Say your full name.
Fionn Louise Wilde.
Your nationality?
Australian.
Australiana. You were visiting Ecuador as a tourist?
Yes.
Once you were in the river, what happened?
Our boat was stopped by three men. They were pointing guns at us.
Where did they take you?
They took us into the jungle.
Did something bad happen in the night?
Yeah, I was sexually assaulted repeatedly.
Months after Fionn Wilde was kidnapped and raped in the Amazon jungle, she's returned and is risking her life one more time.
Being on a police van, surrounded by police, going through the back streets so nobody would see us on the main streets.
The kind of security that they provided us was scary because they thought we needed that much. Yeah, that scared me a lot.
Fionn is on her way to court to identify one of the gang accused in her brutal kidnapping. Police believe he's part of the ruthless drug gang known as the Black Eagles. They've put a bounty on her head. They don't want her to testify.
Going to the tribunal on the bus with our police escort, it was the hardest thing I'd done at that point since being kidnapped. That whole fight flight was coming out. I wasn't running, but it was just, I was again going it head on and I was ready for a fight.
Fionn knows a thing or two about a fight. Fighting crime is what she does. She's a forensic investigator with the New South Wales Police. She also has a passion for adventure. That began a long time ago as the youngest of four children.
Tell me what you were like as a kid.
I think I wasn't a brat, but I seemed to get myself into a lot of trouble all the time. I think I was just, you know, an outdoorsy kid and liked my animals and not my dolls.
You're a very Lego. Adventurous soul.
Yeah, probably, I guess. Yeah, I liked being in nature.
What drew you to go on your trip to Ecuador?
I had recently gone through a divorce. And it was the first time where I was going to be independent woman and I'm going to go out and have a holiday of a lifetime. It's just so small and so spectacular to be able to experience a bit of the Amazon and then a bit of diving with some baby seals on an island in the Galapagos. I mean, I can't imagine who wouldn't want to do that.
Everything went well to start with?
Yeah, well, I think it was in the afternoon we arrived in Ecuador. We flew into Quito.
Quito, Ecuador's capital, is one of the oldest cities in South America. Once a week at the presidential palace, there's the changing of the guard. The traditional costumes draw the tourists, but you don't need to look far to find the real deal. Ecuador is a thoroughfare for some of South America's most ruthless crime gangs and narco-terrorists.
Money laundering, drug trafficking, weapons trafficking, even human trafficking. These are known trafficking routes that are controlled by organized crime syndicates, cartels, gangs.
When we leave here, this place is basically done for an hour. No one will be
Brad Barker runs Halo Corporation, which specializes in counter-terrorism and hostage rescue. He's looking after our safety as we return with Fionn to the jungle near Colombia's border, the place where she was kidnapped.
This is one of the last frontiers left on Earth. You can't dial for an emergency here. No one can hear you and no one can respond quickly in an area like this. Coming here, facing her fears in the exact location where this crime took place is this is the first time I've ever heard of anybody even coming close to this.
I'm aware that going back there will bring things up and bring up memories, but I think I need to go back to Ecuador to heal.
So what we're in essence doing is we're shutting the river down. We're creating a little bubble for our convoy. We've got complete control of the river.
I have to say, the tension rises every time he slows his engine.
My adrenaline was pumping. I was nervous, I couldn't concentrate.
To ease her nerves, Fiona pulls out her camera, just as she did in September last year. Back then, these were her companions. They planned to spend 4 days at a remote eco-lodge.
I remember feeling so alive and like, oh my God, this is the first leg of this holiday of a lifetime. I'm so, so excited.
What was it like? The sky was blue, beautiful day?
Yeah, it was a beautiful sunny day and the water was like, you know, murky brown, but just so warm. Just when you put your hand in the water, it's so warm and the butterflies landing on us in the boat.
You were about 20 minutes in?
Yeah, and I think I heard a shout and the engine of the boat cut. I kind of looked around and I looked up and there was someone on the bank.
They pointed at the boat pilot and said, stop, come here or I'm gonna shoot you. He had no choice but to do what he's told.
There's three guys. One had the pistol, one had the sawn-off shotgun, and another one had a machete.
These kidnappers see boats come by, and they go through a process of target selection. They chose this one based on the three Vs, how visible they were, how valuable they were, and how vulnerable they are. They had guns, they instantly overpowered them, took control, stole all of their stuff, picked some people tactically out of the group, and sent the rest on their way. They grabbed the two girls and disappeared into the jungle.
Five of the tourists were let go. Fiona and 28-year-old British accountant Katie Cox were not. They were marched into the jungle at gunpoint.
At that point, those thoughts of we're going to be executed started to go through my head a little bit.
In this particular case, the kidnappers packed Fiona's clothes and took them with her.
That's an indicator that there was no intention of releasing her anytime soon.
So I was holding on to that. It's okay, I'm gonna be a hostage. But then in my mind, I'm like, oh my God, how many years of my life am I gonna lose?
They walked for about 5 hours before making camp. As the sun set, the gang leader grabbed Fiona.
He made me get in the tent that he'd built. And like Katie was standing outside and she starts screaming. He just flipped out and like said to me, indicated to me at that point, either I shut her up and do what he wants or he'll slit my throat. And I said, Katie, it's gonna be fine. I will be fine. Nothing's gonna happen to me. I'll be fine. That's what I said to her. But in my mind right then, I knew exactly what was going to happen and I knew I had to. Just if I fought, that I'd die. So, and that we both would. So I just did what I had to do.
Fiona was raped 6 times by the leader of the gang.
I don't know. I tried to talk to the guy. I tried to reason with him, broken Spanish. I tried to make him promise that tomorrow I got to see my mum and my dad and my family and my sister. That was the big number one. I could not stop thinking about my sister.
Were you thinking
how much I loved her and how much I don't tell her that enough? All I could think about was, am I going to see her again?
Back in Australia, news of the kidnapping had reached Fiona's sister. She wanted to help, but felt helpless. So too, Australia's Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade.
A couple of times I asked the DFAT guys, so what should I be expecting to do next? And you know, why do you think they've taken her? And they were like, your guess is as good as ours, you know. Like, we don't know what's going to happen next.
What happened next came as a dramatic surprise. In the critical hours after the kidnapping, Ecuador's defence forces were mobilised. 300 police and soldiers were sent to the area. Then, 36 hours after their kidnapping, a search helicopter closed in.
It was very low, it was very loud. This was the first time I saw them panic. They were diving for cover under plants. And then the chopper slowly sort of moved, but continued to hover nearby, like very, very nearby. And they came over to us, and the main guy had gone into the backpack, pulled out his Glock and tucked it into his pants, and he's walked over to us. And he's kind of grabbed Katie and tried to pull her away from me. And I've just gone, like, no. And he looked at me and he said in Spanish to go with them and leave Katie behind.
You think he wanted to?
Yeah, he just wanted to take Katie. Me. Yeah, he wanted to kill Katie.
You weren't going to let him kill Katie?
No, not without me.
With the gang fearing capture, but Fiona and Katie refusing to move, the leader ordered them to run.
I looked back because I didn't want to be shot in the back running away. That was the thing going through my mind, is he's going to shoot us when we run. And he was already running, and then Katie's yanking on my arm, and we're running in the opposite direction, up towards where we can still hear the chopper. And we see it there, and we're waving our arms and screaming and running after it, and it's just cruising off. And we're just like, oh my God, it's gone.
So they kept running, hoping to be rescued. On the jungle's edge, near the Colombian border, a farmer and his wife saw them and saved them. Now Fiona has returned to say thank you to the couple who gave refuge and called for help. In Ecuador, their rescue was big news. The president sent his private jet to fly them back to the capital.
The response was beyond our wildest dreams. We didn't think anyone was looking for us. Well, we knew there were choppers and we were hoping they were for us, but we weren't sure, and we are so grateful, and everyone has been so nice to us.
My view, Fiona did every single thing right and is alive today because of it.
Well, the main guy definitely has a scar and tattoos.
While we were in the jungle, police arrived unexpectedly with a mugshot of a suspect.
And then they said, well, we'd like you to ID him in person.
We were escorted to a court in the northern town of Lago Agrio, bandit country controlled by the drug cartels. The risk of being ambushed is real. An elite force is assigned by the president to protect us. The 23-year-old suspect is most likely Colombian and goes by the nickname The Rat. He arrives under guard. And then Fiona is brought in. In a closed session, she's asked to identify the man. She doesn't flinch.
Coming all the way from Australia, you're a very brave person.
Thank you.
Could you please tell the tribunal if this person is one of the three persons who participated in the kidnapping?
He looks like the youngest of the three.
Unless he gives up the rest of the gang, the Rat faces up to 10 years in prison for kidnapping.
I tell you again, in the name of the Republic of Ecuador, we apologize about what happened. These kind of situations are not usual in our country. Our country is a very safe country.
Before she leaves, Fiona's bravery is rewarded. An audience with the president of Ecuador, Rafael Correa.
That's great. Thank you so much.
A great pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So I feel my sorrow with the words you...
After testifying against her kidnapper, Fiona finally got to head off for a few days to Ecuador's Galapagos Islands. A gift from the president. It was the holiday she'd set out on 8 months ago.
I remember when it was first suggested to me to go back to Ecuador, I was like, oh, I don't know about that. And then it's like, no, it's an awesome decision. Awesome decision to make.
Legs lifted off the ground once.
You're not going to let this experience of last year in Ecuador hold you back in your life at all, are you?
Mm-mm. No. I feel like I should use experiences like this to grow and become a better person, not let it run my life or ruin me.